plenty from cooking with Nancy Chan. I'm just going to cook a very quick spaghetti noodle. My son is going to give me some yum cha dishes, but hang on, I've got to have my noodles. So, very easily, I put in garlic and some chicken, and I'm going to put in my scallop and prawns, and just going to fry. I'm adding some fried onions. Fry this nicely. Put the seasoning that you like, soya sauce. This one has got a bit of chili. Yeah, I forgot. I got something nice. Lemongrass. What's the lemongrass, you know? Yes, you have. Frozen lemongrass, so I just added some water to it. And then you fry till it's dry. Wait, sweetheart, don't make noise, huh? It's my birthday, huh? I've got to cook, huh? I say I don't want to cook, but I want to cook my special noodle. Let this dry out a bit. Then, this noodle is the fresh egg noodle. Fresh egg noodle. It will dry up in this little bit of liquid here. Can you see? The liquid in the wok. Okay. I'll put in the noodles there. Smelling like noodles, he's looking at it. Smelling like noodle. Everyone likes noodle. Now Chinese, he's saying, this noodle, Chinese like it because it signifies long life. Long life for noodles. Because the noodles are long. I love you too, sweetheart. Hang on, don't disturb me. I'm busy cooking, okay? Yeah, I know. Yeah. I love you too. I've already added some... see, I need some more liquid in here. I've already added fried onions just now. Yes. These are already cooked. So I move it to the side. And what I want to is to cook the noodle and add a bit more water. I'll put in the sprouts at the end. Why I'm adding water is just to cook the noodles. And in the meanwhile, I can cut up some chilies too. Are using the same chopping board, just make sure you have washed it, okay, because that's being almost cooked now, so we don't want any raw chicken. I put raw chicken to cut, so make sure. Oh, if you see the chili black like this, means it's rotten on the inside, so throw away the seeds. Your chilies around. Just split, see whether it's black. If it's black, just remove, scrape it off. Scrape it off. Wait, sweetheart. Just throw that chili away and just use this plenty. Okay. Now for Singapore style, it will be yellow like this. If if I want to make it Hokkien and Hokkien style, then I put dark sauce to it, okay? But if you also want Hainan style, it is this color too. Hainan style is this color as well. So stir it till the noodles are cooked. Looking very good. So you can give it a good taste to see whether you need any soy sauce or not. That is all. So I'm just going to take one and try. I don't need so much. For testing, you only need a very little. The noodle is still a bit slightly tough. So when the noodle is slightly tough, it means it needs a little bit of stock or just plain water to cook the noodles properly inside. So cooking is very easy. You got to taste for it, okay? Now I can add some chili liquid seasoning. Just a dash, a generous dash actually. Then I can make it black. Putting this ketchup manis. Ketchup manis is ketchup is sauce, manis is sweet, and a little bit of soy sauce as well. Like that's about 1.5 tablespoon. Tablespoon ketchup manis. This is very very tasty from 1928. Yeah, it was produced from that time when I did the fine food exhibition. The boss came to me, the lady boss, she gave me free ones for my cooking classes. So sometimes I have to hunt for them in the shops. Not all shops sell it, you know. Wait, sweetheart. Okay, all I have to do is taste one more noodle to see whether it's al dente. You can see me eat things, no me. Oh my god. Perfect. It's already cooked. All I have to do is add in my sprouts now. I have my sprouts all ready. My sprouts here. You can put as much as you like. Before anything else, I would just like to add a touch of pepper. You can use black pepper or white pepper. The trouble is when I put this, oh my god, I start to sneeze now. Oh, covered it up. Oh, don't get to my nostril. Then I add in all the sprouts, as much as you like, okay? This is one packet of sprouts. For this quantity of noodles, you can use half a packet. That's plenty actually. So give it a stir or two and it's ready. You can put in your herbs if you have. Herbs like chives, parsley, and I only got some mint here. So I'll just top it with some mint later on. So I don't want to overcook the sprouts. Bless your heart, coming. My pet goat loves the sprouts as well. I love you too. So that's ample. And that's ready for serving. So, all I do is serve it on the dish. I can add some oyster sauce if I like. It's actually optional. Looks good. Since I've got it here on hand, I just add a dash. If you put too much of this, it's going to be too salty. So that's just right for me. Yeah, I know you want it. He wants it too. My bird, he said, I love your chest, sweetheart. Okay, now dish it out on this special plate. Man sao mo kyong. I do not know Chinese, but it's very auspicious. Wealth, long life, and blah, 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 blah. And all these flowers have got meaning, you know. It looks so gaudy, but it's got meaning. So everything is symbolic here. Okay, now get a pair of tongs, serve, and it's ready. Voila! I'm ready to eat my own birthday noodles, but I'm going out for dinner. And after this, my son's going to steam some yamcha goodies for us to enjoy. Right. This is done. All switch off. Long life. See? Long. That's what the Chinese like noodles. And it's not a cake. You know, it's not a cake. It's always noodles, traditional noodles for birthday, for any occasion. Noodles is very auspicious. I've got scallops as well, scallops and prawns here. Okay, now, just wipe the spill on the side. I'm ready. Okay, just wipe up the spill. And here's my birthday noodle. Hey! Please subscribe. Please enjoy my video. Watch to the end and like it and share it. Cooking is so easy. Thank you. Bye.